Welcome back to Lovely Words to this, the, I guess, wrap-up show for season dos of the Ajax Career Mode. And what a fantastic season we had. We captured the Champions League, cup. It was fantastic. I didn't think we'd actually make it all the way, but we did it. We scrapped out a 1-0 victory up against Bayern. On the last day, we recaptured the Eredivisie Cup, but we did lose out on the Orange Cup. So if I were to return next season, that is what is on, you know, the table. Can we win the treble? Can we start a dynasty here at Ajax? Can we start, as I promised at the start of this career mode, a golden generation, you know, of such great Dutch players, kind of in the likes of Johan Cruyff and all those bad boys from back in the day. And the vote, if you haven't checked it out in the last episode, is razor thin, man. It's early on, it was about like 50-50, and I think right now it's 60-40 leaning on me to stay, which I'm fine with. I mean, I love this team. I love playing with this team. My only concern is it was just such a magical season in season two. It just set up so perfectly for us that I don't know if I can recapture those epic moments, man. Like eking out those 1-0 wins, the winner by Ziyech in the Champions League final. Those are just moments that I don't know if we can top. And realistically, you know, if I was a manager in this position, I've won the Champions League. I'd essentially be following the path of like a Jose Mourinho. I am now the hottest prospect on the planet, and every single big club out there that's looking to find the next great manager is going to be coming to my door. I mean, every major team is giving me an offer. Like just right here, look, browse jobs. Bayern Munich, the team we defeated in the Champions League final, says, hey, what's up? What's up? By the way, they finished second in the league. If you see them, that's their league position. They finished second in the league. They're offering me the job, the top job. I can go over here. Borussia Dortmund, who would finish first, apparently, in the season. But, you know, Thomas Tuchel is under a lot of scrutiny recently. Maybe they're looking for, you know, someone to take them further into the Champions League. I could, you know, possibly do that for him. Personally, I'm a bandwagon fan of Borussia Dortmund. I loved them ever since, you know, Jurgen Klopp was there. And I think this would be one of our top choices. If I move, this team would definitely be one of the top choices I would want to go to, with bright young stars like, Ousmane Dembele, Emery Moore, Christian Pulisic. Like, and anywhere I go, I'm going to bring some of the youngsters and players from Ajax over to that team. So, you know, you inject a little bit of Dolberg, a little bit of Ziyech into this club. How do you think it would look, man? How do you think it would look? And you can see everyone in the Bundesliga is vying for me. Wolfsburg, Schalke, you know, Borussia Mönchengladbach, Leverkusen. They're all coming in, man. And here's the crazy thing. All right, I found this glitch out right here. I can exit career mode. I can come back in, right? And it'll reset your job offers. So I could just cycle through all the major leagues in Europe. So I just come back in. And I can browse jobs, and it's going to be different this time. So there we go. I have the top two offers from Russia. I cycle back in. These are the job offers that I'm getting. Boom. The Prem. As you can see right here, Arsene Wenger is definitely on the hot seat. And their league position last season, they finished in fifth for the first time in God knows how many long years. Arsenal has finished out of the top four, and they need some help. Could Hikari Mugen be the coach that Arsenal fans have been wanting for years? Could I fill that void, man? I think Arsenal is one of my top choices as well. There's room there to rebuild. You know, could definitely inject a couple of the Ajax players into there. And I would bring along, you know, the system of building through the youth. So I would really dedicate a lot of their funds into developing like five-star players. Arsenal Youth Academy used to be maybe the best in England a couple of years ago. It just seemed they always had a hot prospect coming through. And there's a little bit of a connection between Arsenal and Ajax with Dennis Bergkamp. Although I'm not quite sure if I want to go to the Prem yet, because look at the other jobs that are being offered to me. Chelsea, who finished third last season. Everton, who finished seventh. Liverpool, I'm not going to touch as a Manchester United fan. Same thing with Man City. But there it is. The Man United job is there for the taking. As you can see here, I can take any of the top four jobs in Italy. And the third really attractive place that I think would be really fun to go is Barcelona. Barcelona, of course, they have the connection. You know, Johan Cruyff went ahead and left Ajax for Barcelona. I don't know if there's still bad blood between that. But in real life, Barcelona is sitting kind of in a weird limbo place. They're, you know, they could still win it, but there have been whispers. Is Luis Enrique the good long-term decision, the good long-term coach? Is Luis Enrique using Messi right? Those types of whispers. Is he the right coach for Barcelona? He's a guy that's kind of on the hot seat. Could a man who went ahead and just won Champions League go into that situation? And I would definitely, and the way that I would play Barcelona is not only, you know, would I buy world-class players to play alongside Messi, Suarez, and Neymar, but I'd like to develop their youth system. You know, there's been a heavy focus. They always like to play and develop great players at the La Masia, one of the finest academies in all of Europe. So I put a lot of emphasis into finding, you know, good Brazilians, good Spanish players, and growing Barcelona from the roots up instead of playing, you know, being a little bit more like Real Madrid over here, who could be interesting too. But I think rebuilding Barcelona, you know, tearing away some of the older parts and rejuvenating them with youth could be something that's an interesting thing to go ahead and watch. But I'd like to hear what you guys think. You know, do any of those kind of strike you as something interesting that you would see, you know, a manager that has just won the Champions League with Ajax, that he would go ahead and move on to a bigger challenge? Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll just put up a straw poll right here. I'm not saying I'm leaving, but if I did, out of those three clubs, Barcelona, Borussia Dortmund, or Arsenal, which one would you most like to see? And speaking of votes for a new series, you guys went ahead and smashed it on your votes for what you wanted, you know, the secondary series that you wanted to see on the channel. Did you want to see the My Player, you know, son of Donald Trump, or China Destroys Football, Road to Glory? And China destroyed the My Player. 73%, 446 votes. That's fucking mind-blowing to me. 446 of you guys want to see the China Destroys, you know, English football career mode. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna start up a Road to Glory. Now the question is, I already told you the concept. Basically, I'm gonna take a team, I'm basically gonna RB Leipzig it. So I'm gonna keep the players, but I'm gonna change the name of it. I might even end up moving the team. Just everything that you would be afraid of, everything that was terrible about RB Leipzig, everything that was terrible about MK Dons, I'm gonna be doing to this team. So I have two choices. I want to do it so that it hurts the most, you know what I'm saying? So I want to do it to a team that has a lot of history, which is very cruel of me. And the two teams that I was gunning for, well, the first one is Portsmouth. Yes, Portsmouth. Portsmouth have been champions of England twice. They've won the FA Cup twice. They were in the UEFA Cup in 2009, but since have fallen all the way down to the fourth division of English football. And I think it would make a lot of sense that a Chinese businessman would come and try to swoop up one of the biggest names that they could while, you know, it was cheap. There's one thing that I know about my people is that we love a good deal. And when something's on sale and it's still pretty good quality, we will swoop. So Portsmouth is the top of my list and my only suggestion from the fourth division. And I have one other team that I'm thinking about doing, and that's from third division. And I just think this is poetic justice. Why not gut and take over MK Dons? The team that was RB Leipzig before RB Leipzig, of course, very famously, they took over Wimbledon. They basically gutted the franchise. They moved the team and were considered probably the most hated football franchise in all of England for a while. Why not give them a taste of their own medicine, buy out the club with all my Chinese monies, rename the club, and then move it somewhere else? Because kind of fuck MK Dons. So those are your two choices. Do you want to stick it to MK Dons, or do you want to be absolute dickholes and gut one of the most storied franchises in English football in Portsmouth? Vote in the eye thingies. I will get so much hate on this career mode. I love it. All right, so you haven't gathered. Now, no gameplay in this episode, just kind of clean up dirty laundry. I will be playing the World Cup qualifiers. Well, not the qualifiers, the group stages in the next episode. We'll squeeze all three in there, see if we advance and that kind of stuff. But I just wanted, you know, to go over the votes and all that stuff. And then round it out, let's do a little bit of squad review. See how the season ended for the lads, huh? All right, let's go through the squad right here, right now. Andre Onana was crucial to our Champions League victory. He basically, like that crucial save up against PSG in the second leg, if not for that, we going out. All right, and our scout feature star, Jerome Peru. You guys have been saying like, oh man, like you can't leave because if you leave, then we're going to lose out on all these great like youngsters and stuff. I'll try to promote all of them. If I do end up leaving, I'll promote all of them before we go. As you can see right here, Christian Meyer, all these kids, all you players, I'm not really going to focus on the you players unless they're like, you know, super, superstars. We're going to keep on moving on. Svilar, I got to play him with more games next season, try to get him up. Kenny Tete has been really, really solid for us in that back three trident. You know, he's had his moments going forward. As you can see, 11 clean sheets, not all too bad. Let's keep on going on. David Sanchez. Getting him back in the Champions League final was so clutch, man. And as you can see, even with the big long-term injury of he was out for like 2 months, still growing, he's up to 88 sprint speed and 88 strength. Just a beaut of a defender. Bramboyne went up by 13 this season. A revelation indeed, aka Bam Bam. Just look at these gross stats going up by plus 24 in marking and slide tackle, plus 22 in interceptions. What's his six? He's an exciting prospect, man, and wow. I can't believe he might be a better prospect, honestly, than Eduardo Rossi. That's crazy. St. Husi has been great since we brought him in. Now up to 90 pace, which is absolutely fantastic. If we can get up his, technical ability, his technical defending abilities, it'll be well. But he stepped in when Sanchez went down. He clutched it up, and I cannot say enough good things about him. Let's keep on going on. Matthias De Ligt. I know he's got great potential. He's gone up by plus 5 this season, so he's on his way. He's only 18 years old, so he's still very, very young. We'll keep on going. Jarrell Wildewald, only 21 years of age and already up to an 80, was great at that kind of left center back role, and also, you know, contributed a little bit in the CDM position. Then Donkadonk, our first choice CDM, and he was a absolute tank, just breaking up everything, man. A destroyer in the midfield, putting out fires. Loving to death. Even with his sprint speed not being the highest, he just seemed to outmuscle everyone. As you can see right here, two goals, two assists, but that's, you know, that wasn't his job. His contributions came in being basically the cover man, the sweeper behind that front three. Eduardo Rossi went up by plus 8 this season. Very nice. Starting to grow in the physicals as well. As you can see, 96 ball control. The boy is a technical genius. Contributed 11 goals and 4 assists in his second season, man. Not even in his first full season, too. Just great. I did not think that he would contribute that much this quickly. Luke Peters, Cedric Voss, these are kind of guys. Brian Dabo, as you can see, extremely well-rounded. Can you see more green? Can you see more shades of green in a man's attributes? As you can see right here, only gone up by plus 1. He's at 26. It's pretty much like he can only go up by maybe 1 or 2 more points. Contributions, 3 goals and 3 assists. Usually played more in a defensive CDM position and left-back position, but he encompasses the total footballer that I strive and like to have in our squad. Going on, Wylon Cyprian, gone up by plus 4 at the age of 23, up to an 81 now, and he is basically kind of a younger, I guess, like a more handsome version of Brian Dabo. Contributed 3 goals and 3 assists. So yeah, basically they're clones of each other. Super athletic, can do it all, can finish, can defend, good strength, good pace. Decent enough height, can head the ball, good technical, but yeah, they're just basically like mini Pogbas, is what I like to have. Manuel Olcedebe, he contributed. Espe Hespersen, all this stuff. Donny van der Beek barely touched him in the second season, but injuries forced him into action. He's gone up by a plus 5 now and scored a handful of crucial goals for us. As you can see, his finishing for CM pretty damn high at 75. Got to get his short passing and his other technical abilities up. He's got fantastic potential. Definitely one to watch. Pablo Galdemez, I hated him because he let in that really stupid goal, but I also have to remember that he's only 21 and he's already at 78. If you look at his stats, they're only going to grow even more. And he is definitely another one, another prized possession. He just needs a little bit more seasoning. Omar El Kajouri was a fantastic free signing. Unfortunately, he was the other one who took a major injury, but before that, he was doing pretty well. 5 goals, 5 assists, pretty good return for someone who was free. Leon Bailey. Almost at 99 sprint speed, 99 acceleration. Absolutely love him. The only thing that we need now is to put up his finishing, and we can definitely make him our own kind of like mini Robin out there on the left side. Oh, lovely. David Klaassen, El Capitano, scoring crucial goal after crucial goal. Now up to an 85. I think this is max potential at age of 25. And look at this, 10 goals and 8 assists. Just another classic, dependable, reliable season from our rock in the central midfield. Keep it moving on, and I'm going to just say it right now. Our MVP of the season goes to who else but my Mongolian general, Hakim Ziyech. Now up to 86. I think his potential is only 85, so he's exceeded that with exceptional play and dark greens like a Christmas tree, and the technical abilities everywhere. It would be too long for me to list, and oh, just tremendous. Look at the return. 15 goals and 13 assists, and even in 38 games played, nearly 40 games played, he averaged a rating of 8.0, and in the Orange Cup alone, averaged over a 9.0. That's how fucking good he was, man. All right, let's keep it going on. Abdelhak Nouri, grown up by +4, growing in the physicals, which is fantastic, and look at his return for a part-time player. A lot of people say that he's the next big thing coming from, you know, the De Toekomst Academy, and it shows. 10 goals and 6 assists in limited play. Very, very nice. We got him. We got the production line going, I must say. Daley Sinkgraven was loaned out for most of the season, but he's gone up almost to an 80 now and is only 22 years of age. I've been flirting with selling him and that, but though looking at his stats, I think we're always going to need a player that can contribute in various, different areas, and that's what he gives, a great utility. Let's keep on moving on. Vlachan Cherny, once again, very, very young. But if we look at those physicals, this kind of snuck up on me. Just his agility is at 99. Anytime a player gets a 99 stat, you have to take notice. Almost up to a 77, going up by +3. Didn't play all too much, only 12 appearances and all that jazz. But definitely, you know, in our plans for the future. Kasper Dolberg had a little bit of a down season. And when I say down season, you know, he was the Golden Boot winner in his first season. But still growing very, very nicely, up to an 82. And we take a look at the stats. 15 goals and 8 assists, not all too bad for a return. Has potential to be special and, you know, had a couple of lingering injuries early on in the season that kind of hampered him. Adam Milson, you know, not contributing all too much, but he had the same amount of appearances, as you can see, as Vaclav Cherny. 1 goal and 1 assist, but I gotta play him more because look at those stats, man. Not only is he blazingly quick, I think he's our best combination of speed and strength. 97 sprint speed and 81 strength. I gotta get him more. The only thing that sucks about him is that crossing. That crossing is absolutely horrendous. Alexander Isak, gone up by +2, barely played him this season. Zivkovic is nice. Moussa Dembele. Moussa, the enigmatic case himself, is weird, man. He's gone up by +1. He scored 1 goal, gave 1 assist, and then just disappeared. He could not hit the broadside of a barn. Do we hold on to him? Do we sell him? I'll put up a vote right over here. You know, let me know. Okay, moving on. Irvin Lozano contributed 2 goals and 5 assists in that crucial goal, I believe, up against Real Madrid on that counterattack. And he is a blazer, man. 99 acceleration, almost to 99 sprint speed and agility. Gotta get his finishing is almost up to 80 as well. And he's a roadrunner, man. I absolutely love him, and he completes our attack. Once we signed him and I played with him for 2 matches, I knew that athletically we could make a run. We could make a run in the Champions League. This guy, make no mistake, I built the team and I needed the tools, and this man was a weapon. Mbappe Lawton was loaned out, I think, for a good amount, but somehow grew by +3 up to a 77, announced himself up against Manchester City the other day. Definitely someone to watch. And that is pretty much it, guys. I would say, you know, I already announced my MVP, but for my young player of the year, which is a player that is under the age, well, 21 or under, I am gonna have to go with young Draquinho. At the age of 17, he was able to contribute 11 goals and 4 assists. Absolutely dynamic. It was close between him and Abdelhak Nouri. I will say that. And yeah, that's pretty much going to be it for this episode. Go ahead, remember to vote and all the things. Go ahead, if you haven't checked it for some reason, check out the last episode. If I've changed your mind, maybe you actually want me to move on now. I think a change of scenery and going to a new team can definitely benefit the channel by bringing in fans of different teams. I know there's a lot of diehard Ajax fans that only watch this for the Ajax. And if I do move on and this is the last time that I see you guys, I'd like to say that it's been a pleasure, guys. You guys, all you guys have been like super fucking awesome. But I hope that you go ahead and you stick around because you like me and the personality that I bring. So yeah, if anything that I said has changed your mind in either direction, do you want me to stay? Do you want me to go? Go ahead and go back to the last episode and put in your vote. If you guys want to hear about it, I got a couple more things coming down the road. Here's a little bit of a sneak preview. I got a couple ideas in my head, video ideas, you know, kind of one-off stuff. One talking about how EA has essentially killed off career mode in a way and how we can kind of bring it back. Also can start making videos. I got a future of Ajax. It sucks that David Neres and Justin Kluivert aren't in the game, but I've simmed ahead so you can kind of see what they look like at full potential, and it is scary. And then a couple of guys have also been requesting some tutorial videos on how to improve your game. How do you win up against legendary? How do you win up against world class? And you know, I got a couple of those in the works, just trying to balance that and work and have a girlfriend and eat food and poop and sleep. There's just only so many hours in the day. But yeah, that's pretty much it for me, guys. Hopefully you guys did enjoy, you know, season dose of the Ajax Career Mode. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for coming along with me on this journey. And yeah, my name's Be Honest. Hopefully you guys are having a wonderful day. Remember to stay yourself, stay humble, be weird.